Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. Now, this is somewhat of a special thing that I'm doing right now. I was reading like the official Delta Force 2 strategy guide yesterday, and I realized that Operation Common Resolve actually has two hidden missions. And the way to access them is to actually grab a document in Mission Counterpunch, which I did not know existed the first time around that I played this game, played this mission. Apparently, if you grab the document and extract successfully, you get two new missions. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and let's see how that goes. Of course, I'll be cutting over to actually addressing the mission after this. So see you guys then. Strange. Should be a guy right there, actually. I wonder where he is. The ghillie suit makes it to the point where, you know, you're practically invisible. Which is something that I really like. The fact that you can be invisible in this game. Took some fall damage there, but that's okay. We're gonna go ahead and grab this document right now. And it's right here on the ground. What's strange is, despite the fact that, you guys see that shiny thing over there? That's the document. And as soon as you walk over it, yep, you'll get that sound, which tells you. Where the hell was Alpha shooting all this while? Anyway, up we go. And
APC's making a run for it!
No, it's not, I already destroyed it. And yeah, now we just need to extract successfully. And that's a mission success for us. Okay, so with that, I'm pretty sure that I already showed you guys the intelligence that we gained from that, from the back of that truck. I don't know why it was there, maybe they forgot to pick it up. But that unlocks this secret mission here called Bounty Hunter, which will in turn unlock another mission for us in Operation Common Resolve. So here's how Bounty Hunter goes. Classified missile guidance systems are being illegally loaded for shipment in your area. Divert from your current mission and confiscate them. So, yeah, I mean, despite having a global biological threat, we are instead trying to obtain the missile guidance systems for, well, the biological threat might be a priority, but until the time we figure out where it is, we can't really make a move. And that's how it was intended to be. However, we have already taken care of the biological threat, and we never really knew about the secret missions until we read the strategy guide. So right now we are actually diverting from Operation Global Enforcement to go over and target Bounty Hunter at this point in time. So I suppose something has caught our attention about this thing here. So let us go and take a look at the mission briefing here.
You are being diverted from your primary mission. A major arms deal is about to take place near your location, and the National Command Authority wants the situation handled immediately. DIA sources have given us the location of classified missile guidance systems that are being loaded onto a boat for shipment. You are ordered to confiscate the boat and any weapon systems already on board. Bravo will be inserted east of the main camp. Take control of the boat and make your way upriver to the extraction point. The boat and its contents will be turned over to the Justice Department for use as evidence. Any weapons still in warehouses and not yet on board are to be destroyed.
Roger that. So, basically destroy the warehouses and confiscate the boat. There seem to be quite a bit of, quite a few, well, how do I put this, helicopters on the map, and I don't see where there might be a boat. Is this a river? Seems strange. Use the sniper rifle. No sergeant charges, I'll take the loss with me. Maybe I should take sergeant charge. Let's see.
Bravo, King 6. The dock is west of your position. Secure the boat and proceed downriver to the rendezvous point.
Roger, King 6. Attempt number 3. Now, this is a pretty straightforward mission. All you have to really do is snipe the enemies out. But, yeah, even that can be pretty difficult. We are zeroed into 100 meters. Let's zero into 300 instead. 3 enemies down. 4 down. Yeah, there's somebody right there. There's somebody running over there. Yeah, I'm not leading my shots enough. I'm gonna let that guy go for now, and we'll get him later. We'll definitely get him later. Should be at least one person on this board as well. I wonder if you're gonna be able to see him from here. Or maybe he spawns later and just decides to climb onto the boat later. But the thing is, we could have just stolen the boat, commandeered it, without having to do all of this. Except, you also need to get rid of all the ammunition here, which makes it necessary to commandeer it. Now, one of the reasons why I'm looking at the ground while walking is the fact that somebody's shooting at me. Probably that guy over there. We'll get to you. I don't think the people close to the objective are, like, far away from the objective are any threats. I don't think they can actually shoot you. There's a wind that is apparently 16 kilometers north, but it tends to make the bullet drift to the east instead. I don't know how to read the site. Just letting you guys know. I'm just winging it from my previous experience. 400 meters. I think that guy's dead, but I would like to still just make sure once. No, that guy was not dead. Good thing I made sure. Otherwise, I would have been in a world of trouble later. That's one guy dead in there. There are definitely more people in there. Good thing about this game is, even though you cannot really use bullets to get rid of vehicles anymore, you can still get rid of boxes using bullets. Which is pretty good, if you ask me. Again, I'm trying not to take any fall damage while going down. Last time around, there was somebody over there. I don't see them anymore this time around, but doesn't mean they aren't there. Oh, there you are. Whoops. I was zeroed into a much higher value, being the reason why I sort of overshot that target there. Now, somebody else is shooting at me. I can't tell who it is. From here, at least. You just had to stop as soon as you took my shot, didn't you? It's like you had foresight. Full knowledge of the fact that I'm about to shoot, and you just decided to stop right then and there. This game does that. The moment you shoot, the enemies will just stop. Probably to make it easier on inexperienced players. But for most people, it has the unintended side effect of making the game a little more difficult. Where am I being shot from? And that's another problem with this game. It's difficult to tell where you're being shot from. Somewhere over here? I can't tell. Okay, that guy. Well, sir, you need to die. You definitely need to die. That guy was actually getting pretty close. If I wasn't prone, I probably would have died. Actually, no, it was not that bad. Oh, there you guys are. For whatever reason, those guys are such great sharpshooters that they were able to shoot at me from all the way over there. Well, I mean, the ranges aren't that extreme, it's just like a 200-300 meters, to be honest, and that's pretty much within the scope of modern engagements. I think modern engagements mostly take place over a range of 400 meters, so I would say that's pretty realistic. It's not like the old days where you had to, you know, get close to the enemy until you could see the white of their eyes before you could shoot. I see you. I see you. You were over there, now you're here. Bullet through the noggin for you, and for you too, a bullet through the face. Is that a dead enemy then? Nope, that was a very much alive enemy. And so is this. And so is this. Strategy is a big part of this game. A big part. Maybe I should take out as many of these boxes from here as I can. Oh hey, that thing has a window on that side. Okay, we'll get to it. I'm just gonna keep prone for now and try to get an angle on the window. Ah, there you are. Two of you. And one here. I wonder why you did not get alerted. But well, your mistakes cost you your life. And you should really cherish it, you know. It's a very dear gift. Not everyone gets one. A lot of people are dead before they're even born. Whoops. I sort of meant to shoot at that thing from the outside, but I messed it up. And I'm pruning here because, I just want to keep my profile a little low. Trying to see if there are any enemies left. Maybe I'll refer to the map for that. Not that it actually helps any because, well, we can't even tell where we are. I think we're on this hill here. We were on these hills. Now we came to this hill here. And the boat should be here, but the map for this level does not work. So, yeah, we're pretty much on our own for this. Ah, I see. I'd actually not seen you before. The sounds of your screams are pleasurable to my ears. I'm still gonna maintain some degree of cover for myself, for my own sake. You know what? Let's do this. Yeah. And I'm gonna repeat the same protocol on the other side as well. Just let me check if there are any enemies near the door here. Can't see any. Through the window. Again, can't see any. Here's to hoping that I don't get shot through the back. Awful everywhere. That's a line from the movie Hacksaw Ridge. For those of you who have not watched it, I would highly recommend that you go ahead and do so. One of these ships contains contraband that we are pretty practically trying to obtain and essentially turn over to the local authorities. But until we find said contraband, we need to destroy all the equipment inside of these here buildings. Again, I'm trying to keep as much cover as possible while investigating these buildings. I think I have taken out most enemies inside of that building there. I can't tell if there are any inside here, but I will be chucking a grenade in, just to be sure. Okay. There was one guy there. Somebody's shooting from all the way over there. And I'm guessing that that guy is a sniper. Based off the sound of his weapon. Okay, there's a guy there. I'm just going to... Bullets were whizzing past him, no longer. Now, we need to be a little careful during this infiltration. I think we have gotten rid of all the enemies in that room over there, but just to be safe, I'm gonna eat another grenade here, and... Proceed to the extraction point. Now, where is the extraction point? The boat, you mean? I suppose so. It's one of these boats here. My heart is racing right now, and yeah, I don't want to get shot out by any of these snipers. Where is this guy? Ah, right here. I see. A little more to the left. It's strange, it says wind north 16 kilometers per hour, but at the same time... This was the boat that we needed to proceed to, and we are proceeding to this boat. Okay, the boat is moving, yay! I suppose that's why there were all the enemies on the outskirts. Is that an enemy? Does not seem to be the case. Now, I think one of the things about this boat is that it has bulletproof glass. So it's difficult for you to get shot, really. But if anybody starts shooting,
King 6. There's a patrol boat headed upriver. Your position.
Upriver. What does upriver mean? Not that direction, I suppose. It's maybe that direction. I guess we need to take those guys out. Oh yes. Sadly, I'm all out of
fuel. King 6. You've got hostiles along the east bank.
I do? No, I don't. I think I took them all out. I mean, the boat is coming, but I don't know if it's got shooting powers. I don't think it does. There are no hostiles on the east bank. I took them all out. I think this mission was supposed to be played stealthily.
Bravo, this is King 6. We have reports of snipers along the river.
Yeah, I took as many of them out as I could. I don't see any enemies on this boat, so... I'm just gonna chill for now. Unless that was an enemy. No, that was not.
Bravo, this is King 6. There's another boat heading your way.
Where? Okay, that's a sniper. Well, I think as long as I'm inside this thing, I'm safe because, well, no shots can actually hit me from here. Yeah. None of the shots can actually get to me, so I think I'm safe. However, there are...
Black Widow, this is King 6. Bravo has the boat at the rendezvous point.
Roger that, King 6. Black Widow is inbound.
So I'll just leap through here. Okay, they've got 50 cals. So the 50 cal is the only bullet that can penetrate this mortal shell, so to speak. And we're all out of ammo. if those enemies try shooting at us or try boarding our boat, we will unleash hell upon them. I'm just trying to hit as many of the enemies that I can see. Good thing is, being prone, it makes difficult being hit. Makes it difficult to be hit. Let me stay over onto this side, so that I don't accidentally get shot by any of those guys. Would have liked to take that guy out, but yeah. I would say that I got lucky with this mission. Also, a good thing that I did not bring the...
Good job, Bravo. Stand by for pickup.
Roger, King 6, and since there's fire over my head, I'll just lay in here until the Black Widow takes care of them. So then, see you guys later. And that was that. That was mission Bounty Hunter. And I think there was supposed to be another mission here. I'm not sure. I guess not. It was just this one special mission right here. I thought there was supposed to be two missions, but I guess I was wrong. There was only one mission. So, yeah. So that was that for Mission Bounty Hunter, the bonus mission in this campaign. And, yeah. When we come back next time, we will be continuing on with Global Enforcement. I mean, for you guys, I guess it'll be like the first mission of Global Enforcement, which is Claim Jumper. But for me, I've already completed four of these missions, and I will be tackling Fallout after this. But yeah, for you guys, the next time we come back, we will be continuing with Operation Global Enforcement, or rather starting off with it. So until then, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Take care. Farewell, fellow things.